My color commentator, Snow. How you doing, Snow?
I'm doing all right. We've had some stream issues, but hopefully those are all resolved now. The teams have been picked. Any thoughts?
Going into this, I believe this is the semifinals, so they are playing for second place to win. This is a best of five, so we'll find out who ends up being in the finals. But as of right now, I believe we have on blue side, it's gonna be tipping the Tipables. And on the red side, it is gonna be Olympus Gaming. So far, I believe they've changed out for tipping the Tipables. I believe they swapped out their mid laner. I think they have a sub. I can't remember. He might be. I can't remember if he was the if he is their main. But Tipped the Tipables have had a pretty good season overall. I think they finished top of the standings, if not somewhere up there, in regards to the standings. So from what we've seen, Tipped the Tipables can perform very well. They can once they get the lead, if they stay on course, they generally maintain it. It's they don't tend to let their lead slip as much as the rest of the teams. But Olympus Gaming also is one of the better teams in the league, so we'll see how that plays out. But looking at their picks, what do you make of the Graves jungle on Tippin' Tippables by Ray?
I really love Graves jungle right now. He's just a super strong pick. He's one of the or most contested jungle pick right now. And as you said, they control games, so if they can get Graves snowball and if he can gank Ahri, get her ahead, they're just gonna have a much easier time of snowballing than I think Olympus Gaming. Yes, Olympus Gaming has the LeBlanc and everybody no one likes facing a fed LeBlanc. But with the Poppy and Zyra disengage, I think that Tip and the Tipables just have an easier snowball time.
All right, so we're loaded in, and here we go. Game one is gonna start for the playoffs. Is there an issue with the game starting? I don't see anything. Do you see anything on your screen?
Nah, this did it. This is just a normal spectator bug.
It'll clear up.
Resolve itself.
All
There we
right,
go.
there we go. Here we are. So game one of Tippin' the Tippables versus Olympus Gaming is here to start. So looking at the ADC picks, Jhin and Varus, now in patch 7.5, with it is 7.5, yeah. 7.5 lethality nerfs. So there's gonna be quite a bit of a slight difference in how powerful the ADCs are. They're still pretty good, in my opinion. How about you? What do you think about the new changes?
Well, 7.5 also brought a slight nerf to Deathfire Touch.
30
Its
seconds
AD
until
scaling
minions
is not
spawn.
nearly as good as it was. It's still great, and I still think both these ADCs are safe picks. I prefer Jhin to Varus because I just feel like he has more damage, especially with that fourth shot, than Varus can dish out. But with the Tahm Kench, that's such a good support to counter Jhin, because as soon as you see that fourth shot go off, Tahm Kench is just gonna eat him up, and that negates all the damage. So
Minions have
this
spawned.
bot lane is gonna be very interesting. I like the Tahm Kench pick, not only for the fourth shot, but also because it can negate a lot of the Zyra damage. So let's just see how this laning phase goes for both teams.
So, looking to start off, it's gonna be a pretty standard, no invades happening today, for game one. But Ray will start on his red side. Meanwhile, T-Dubnit will be taking his blue. So slightly quicker, slightly less damage taken by Ray. Actually, quite a bit less damage. Still at full health, whereas T-Dubnit taking a bit of damage. But so right now, we're gonna look at bot lane here. Or, never mind. We'll be at mid. Keiko going in, trying to distortion and gets poked out by Zaxxent with a very excellent Q from that Ahri.
Yeah, that level of Jungle too. That's Zyra is so good for leeching because, as you said, Graves was at full health after his red buff. That's just gonna help him in his entire clear. He took an interesting path, in my opinion. He went from red to wolves to blue, and I expect that to be an early invader gank on his part.
I think he's gonna go for that invade. And T-Dominant is at about half health, and he's got vision on it.
Uh-oh.
Here's a fight breaking out. Flash out of T-Dominant to get away. Kekkle is collapsing in, but Ray is just gonna back out here and get out with the flash burnt.
Super good on the part of Ray. He's going back.
He's still looking for it, and Kekkle's moving in, and so is actually Fat Man Puffin. He's actually gonna come down from top, but they can't claps in on him, and Keiko here with the chain, distortion in, and nothing but a little bit of poke. Scare him off a little bit.
Yeah, mid's just gonna be a back and forth skirmish for a while. LeBlanc is great in the Ahri, but if the Ahri plays it right, they can just trade the same amount of damage. Lots of poke bot lane.
Yeah, that was actually a very good grasping roots by the Zyra there. Managed to lock him down, and then Khonsu with the follow-up to W there.
Lots of skirmishes back and forth.
Ray ganking that top lane. But Fat Man Puffin doesn't burn anything and just walks away from the damage. Chino Sensei is just gonna have to farm it out. He's taken quite a bit of poke compared to Khonsu. Khonsu still has three potions. Well, actually, Chino Sensei's only used one, so Khonsu does have a slight advantage there. But
Whitemore is actually pretty right now, so they gotta wait for that mana to come back from Zyra before they can poke it out again. That's kinda what this bot lane is gonna be.
And a Zaxxent with a very good charm there. Keiko getting just enough on the ignite, but it's gonna be a 1-for-1 there. Zaxxent igniting at the same time, and they both died to ignites there.
Classic mid lane right there. You think you have the advantage until you power dive. It was good that Zaxxent was able to trade that kill and he didn't just die, but first blood did go over the block.
Yeah, with that skirmish there in mid, I feel like Zaxxent actually moved up a little bit too far and got in turret aggro range a little bit too soon.
Yeah, the chain landed just at the right time to stun him under tower, and then easy. I don't know why Keiko stepped forward, because he was dead under tower. He didn't need to step up to use the ignite, but it's still 1-for-1, and he got first kill, so not the worst thing that could happen.
Yeah, meanwhile, top lane, Octomage used teleport to get back into the lane, so Fat Man Puffin does have the advantage there. So he might be able to make a play if they get a ward behind bot lane. But right now, not really looking good for Chino Sensei. He's kind of forced to just farm it out.
Yeah.
Can't really apply pressure there.
Yeah, I don't expect a TP gank to come from Fat Man Puffin just because until Chino gets the Chains of Corruption, because they don't really have any CC other than that.
Meanwhile, T-Dominant actually coming in for that gank here. Goes in with the Q, but only manages to put a little bit of damage there. Force him back a little bit, but it looks like Sightmore, Khonsu are gonna go back. Meanwhile, we're gonna have a pause here. So, looking at it right now, gold lead slightly in favor of Tip and the Tipables. They have about 300 gold over Olympus Gaming. But looking at the items here, so we see Ahri with the Codex, or I'm sorry, yeah, that's the Fiendish Codex, I'm sorry. And then LeBlanc has Chapter. It looks like Khonsu has disconnected due to internet troubles, so we'll have a pause. Pauses are gonna be three per side or 5 minutes of total pause time each per team, whichever one runs out first. But back to discussing the mid lane there. So looking at the purchases, who do you think has the advantage here in terms of items?
Well, honestly, when I play LeBlanc or Ahri, I always go lost chapter first just because I like the extra mana because you can do a lot more with it. And I run CDR on my rune, so the CDR from Phoenix Codex isn't that important to me. But I don't like Zaxxent buying four pots. I feel like that's a little unnecessary. Two pots would serve him well because now Pekkle actually has boots advantage over him, which might not seem like a lot in the early game, but that can make a difference between an Ahri Orb of Deception or Charm landing. So I have to give advantage to Pekkle. Both their ignites are going to be up, and they're both going to be sick soon. So if one of the junglers ganks, that could be another free kill.
Yeah, so looking at the items, so actually before the pause, Ray was actually coming to bot side to counter gank T-Dubnet's move to make a play there, but he didn't arrive in time, so Khonsu just kind of got poked out, and he disconnected around that time. But he actually was backing right before the pause, so he actually had an item disadvantage. If you see that T-Dubnet had the Skirmisher Saber. So he had to completed half of a jungle item, whereas Ray was sitting on just the Hunter's Machete. So if he had gone in there, had he been there on time, would that have possibly been worse off for him?
I think so, because if you're looking at the sides, he was too, so there's like nothing he could have done except auto-attack, and Graves auto attacks don't really do that much this early in the game. We see Khonsu did reconnect, but one thing that I want to point out is that Jayce is actually losing to Poppy in CS. I feel like Fatman Puffin is focusing way too much on oaking out Octomage and not enough on farming, because you have the range advantage, so you should win that CS trade. So hopefully he stops trying to go for the fights, because that's a really tanky Poppy, even level 6. So he's not going to be able to solo kill him unless Octomage steps up a little too forward. So he just needs to focus on farming, get his Black Cleaver and his Yomus, and just do damage to the carries. And because, yeah, you're not going to be able to kill that Poppy. Not without help, anyway.
Yeah, he hasn't even backed. Like you said, he's only got 28 farm. He's sitting on a Corrupting Potion that has no more stacks any longer, and we're back. Meanwhile, Poppy went back and then teleported back in lane with the Ruby Crystal and a cloth armor with boots. So Batman really should be trying to farm this out to at least buy more items before coming back into lane. Meanwhile, Kekkle coming in with a very good gank from T-Dubnet and Nevosi. Nevosi kind of didn't really need to be there with T-Dubnet, but it looks like they're going to make a play for Dragon here. Ray is just going to have to do his red buff. I don't think he can contest it. So Kekkle and T-Dubnet and Nevosi going to work on that Cloud Drake. So Cloud Drake is the first one. Hopefully we'll see something more exciting that they'll try to contest over. But very, very easily gone to Olympus Gaming. Tipping the Tipables did not have any vision at all. But I guess after seeing your Ahri get blown up by 3 in mid, I guess you would say that it's almost a given that they're gonna just go straight for Dragon after.
Yeah, I like the Cloud Drake pickup. A lot of people don't necessarily think that Cloud Drake's a priority, but after that pick mid, that is essentially a free Dragon. And you want to get as many dragons as possible, because when that Elder Drake spawns, it just adds to the true damage burn, which could mean the difference between a kill. and someone surviving, like if Varus Q hits someone and they don't have that rig, that person might live with like 5 HP, and after that you're just gonna get super killed. So get those dragons as many as you can.
Yeah, and you see Pat during that whole dragon skirmish there, or mid gank and dragon attempt. Fatman Puffin actually went back. He's getting ganked right now by Ray, but I think he'll get just away with the flash. Almost dies to the Graves ult there, but manages to get away. But he did actually. I'm sorry. He did actually use teleport to get back into lane. He bought a serrated Dirk and then teleported back into lane to try and farm it back up. And he actually did kind of. I don't think he made up a little bit of ground, but yeah, he's sitting on a serrated Dirk and corrupting potion, and he's not really.
All right. So Poppy actually went back and got Ninja Tabi's first item, which is actually like. Really something that you don't see. Oh, Ray yelling for an aggressive, so that'll take
it. Optimage just popping Fatman pretty hard. Might be a kill there for Optimage, and he does get it. Meanwhile, Zaxxon dashing in, gets the ignite on Kekkle, and Tiedemann can't really stop that. So
Zaxxon
Ray
actually had the kill, but he flashed over the wall anyway just to make sure.
Just to make sure.
Yeah, as I was saying, so Ninja Tabi's actually negates so much damage because it gives 30 armor and it blocks 12% of the damage from auto attacks. So if Octomage didn't have Ninja Tabi's, that could have been a 1-for-1 or a 1-for-0 because Octomage could get power range. A great pickup early by Octomage. I expect a Sunfire. Yeah, going for a Sunfire next, stacking that armor. Jace is gonna have a very, very difficult time without the help of Vi.
Yeah, and looking at the items in bot lane, you see the BF sword out of Chino Sensei. Meanwhile, Khonsu goes for the Serrated Dirk, and then he gets up cloth armor. So, not sure what that cloth armor. I mean, it would help with Varus, but. Cloth armor, I guess he's going Ninja Tabi, maybe?
Yeah, I expect the Ninja Tabi because you have Jace, Vi, and Varus on the other team. So that 30 armor is just going to help a lot.
Meanwhile, Slightmore kind of out of position there. Has to flash to get away, but Chino Sensei, heal coming out of Khonsu. Chino Sensei might be able to get the kill here. Flashes up to get the kill. Nivosi devours Chino Sensei to try and get away, but Ray with the excellent ult to finish off that fight in bot, and they go 2-for-1 in bot lane.
Kekkle just solo kills Zaxxon as well, burning the ignite and the flash, but Octomage going aggressive onto the base. Yeah, Batman Puffin, you can't fight that Poppy anymore. That's one tanky Poppy.
Yeah, and Ray is gonna have to push this up. They probably could get first tower here if they had focused it solely, but I respect the decision not to overstay your welcome there.
Yeah, Vi was headed bot. I don't know. Now they're pinging that Vi was there, but
yeah, and actually you see Kekkle moving down the river trying to make a play, but he might die that. But no, just gonna clear out that ward and tribush.
Next dragon is going to be another Windrake. That's gonna be up in exactly a minute. Lots of bot OG. I think they're actually gonna try and get some power.
Yeah.
Are coming down, so this could be a potential collapse.
I don't think they're going to be able to put enough damage on it to threaten the first tower blood. But if you, I'm sorry?
They're trying.
They're trying for it. And Ray get the kill on T-Dominant. Nivosi getting finished off by Zaxxon dashing in with her ult. And it looks like it's going to be just a 2-for-nothing. They did save. Tipables did save their tower, and Dragon first dragon for them might be possible here. They might be just doing... Oh, yeah, they're just gonna take that first Tower Blood and dragon, because T-Dominant is back in the base, because he died during that fight. Meanwhile, first Drake for them will be the Cloud Drake again.
So that's a one-for-one split on Cloud Drakes. If they are, they should, this should be here. I don't know why Jin is that, you know. Jin is there to go make some pressure on Tower while Graves and Poppy stick around with the dragon. So that's 25 extra moves for both team out of combat. Tip and Tipables grouping is trying to pressure on Tower. But with the long buff turret used, it does more minion damage to minions, so easy wave clear. Everyone's grouping around mid. I question that decision by Team OG. They should keep their Varus in Tomcatch bot, because that tower's like a 4-shot.
Yeah, that misplay for that push bot for that first Tower Blood. And if you guys didn't read patch notes, first tower gold bonus did get nerfed slightly. It's still a decent bonus, but it's a couple. I believe it's like 200 less or 100 less. Can't remember exactly.
Still 100% worth to get first tower. Don't take that as don't get first tower.
Right.
Extra gold. So yeah, Varus and Jin. No, Varus and Tomcatch. They should. That should be the tower pickup. Even up the tower trade. Or they can freeze the wave.
Yeah, and actually Ray is on his way to try and make something, try and defend it, but he realizes there's three there, he's just gonna have to give it up. Meanwhile, actually, Khonsu and Swipemore are going top lane, this lane swap, actually. T-Dominant getting got sent on an abyssal voyage by Nivosi, and the three-man gank again. Once again, a three-man mid lane gets the kill on his accent.
So no one's bot lane. We've officially abandoned the bot side of the map. Both teams, lots of top and mid focus. Good abyssal voyage by Nivosi to deliver T-Dominant. Free assault and battery, burn the flash and the ignite and the ulti from Zach's end, so that's a lot down on his heart. Very successful. Easily another gank, but he's actually going bot lane now, trying to soak up that wave and push it out.
Alright, so Khonsu's gonna back here. Looks like he's already got that Yomu's Ghost Blade, so he's looking to pick up the rest of his items, but Octomage is gonna dive and the ult out of Khonsu is just gonna finish off Fat Man Puffin. Aquamage might die to... Oh! Khonsu didn't accidentally clicked on Swipemore, I think, and healed the wrong person. But T-Dominant is there. Heckle is gonna lock down with the chains, and Khonsu looks like to be a dead man. Heckle getting the kill there. So it's a 1-for-1. Or 2-for-1, I'm sorry. Batman Puffin dies in exchange for Octomage and Khonsu. Actually, very well played by Olympus Gaming there.
Yeah, that was so unfortunate on the part of Khonsu. His heal hits. He must have been hovering Swipemore instead of Octomage. It happened, so Octomage goes down. Lots of focus on this top lane tower now by Olympus Gaming. If they can get that and get the tower advantage, that would be great for them.
Teleport coming out of Octomage, and Ray is there too. They might be looking to try and collapse. Heckle does get the chains on Octomage, but looks like T-Dominant is going to go down there. And the canceled teleport out of Fat Man Puffin realizes that there's quite a bit of damage that's going to be coming down from all of them. And Khonsu rotates up to get that tower top lane. First tower bot for Tippin Sippables are down.
Really good synergy on the part of Octomage and Ray. I don't know if it was accidental or not, but Ray threw out the end of the line, and Octomage, Keeper's Verdict, by up into the air so that when the end of the line gets back, it's timed perfectly with the keeper's verdict. So Vi, there's no way for her to get out of that.
And Batman Puffin gets finished off by Octomage once again. Khonsu landing all four shots, but Flash coming out of Nivosi to get away. So they'll take just one kill and back away. Meanwhile, mid lane tower getting taken down by Tipables, and that's gonna be all outer towers, or all outer towers being taken by Tipables. I'm sorry, my words are getting tripped up on my lips, and can't talk today.
Alright, so no more objectives for Tipables. That's reasonable right now, because I don't think they're strong enough to see this tier 2 third. They're gonna be up in about 40 seconds. I expect there to be some contested contest from Olympus Gaming, because you have a 6-2 LeBlanc who can deal a lot of AoE damage, so if you group Tipables up around somewhere like Dragon, that can easily be a one team fight with the Chains of Corruption and the LeBlanc. Looking for scuttle control though.
Yeah, and this third Dragon that's up is gonna actually be another Cloudrake, so excellent fight here for Tipables. Gonna take two, looking for a third maybe? Unfortunately, gets locked down by the chains, and I think they're just gonna go. It looks like they're thinking about Baron here. Yep, they're gonna make their way towards Baron. TWNet is down, so they can't contest it with Smite. But Olympus Gaming might look to consider and win this fight if Tipping Tipables are low here. Batman Puffin is pretty low, though. Excellent dash over the wall by Zach Sent, getting Batman Puffin, preventing that steal, but Chino Sensei is going to get locked down, I believe. No? Gets away. With the help of Nivosi, taking the Abyssal Voyage to block those curtain calls.
So what they can do is send Poppy top and get a split push going just to pressure top lane and group 4 mid or bot. I think they should take Dragon first. That looks like Graves is going to solo that right now. But yeah, get Poppy in a solo lane because maximize your Baron efficiency. Grouping 5 right now is not smart in my opinion, just because OG has a lot of wave clear with the Barris, LeBlanc, and Jace. So yeah, Poppy's going top. Jin and Graves are actually going to push bot out, while Ahri and Zyra stay mid. 1-2-2.
Yeah, and Nivosa getting poked down quite a bit. A lot of damage from Zach Sent. Zach Sent,
that's not a good sign for Team Olympus Gaming. When you're frontline tank, you can almost get one shot by a charm.
Looks like Khonsu is out of position there. And the Assault and Battery coming out of TWNet. Ray is trying to make his way and manages to get the double kill there. Ooh, very well played by Ray to get that double kill on Kekkle and TWNet. Slight misplay, I would say. I feel like they could have played that a little bit better, but unfortunately, Poppy's just gonna do work on that top lane tower, and gonna 2v1 here, Nivosi and Fatman Puffin. I think she's just gonna shrug off all this damage here.
Yeah, Baron minions helping her out. Actually, this is a blast from Fatman Puffin. Nivosi is really taking Baron minions.
Yeah, Zaxxent gonna be dashing in to try and get the kill. Does manage to get the kill on Nivosi. Octomage still trying to do work. Almost kills Fatman Puffin, but very excellent stun out of a TW in it to prevent the kill on Fatman Puffin. Zaxxent did get spotted out by a ward, and the very, very tip of the arrow from Chino Sensei just hits him.
So we're 23 minutes into the game. Tip and the Tipables with a pretty dominating lead right now. The kills may not seem like that much of a difference, but it's 6 towers to 1, which is really big in this stage of the game. It's a lot of extra people in this area. So you have an 8-0 Graves with Phantom Dancer, Yogi, and Warrior, and now has a Vamp Zone. So he can, as we saw earlier, he can 1v2 LeBlanc and Vi. Vi's so squishy at this stage. Went for the Tri-Force.
Yeah, hasn't hit any of those shots except just the first one. Tito managing to dodge the rest. So Kansu kind of using the ult just to poke him and scare him away, and manages to. It sure was. Nivosi devours TW in it to get away, and is threatened by that Octomage. Just plenty of damage coming out of him. Meanwhile, Kekko trying to dive the backline. Almost does kill, but Zaxxent is going to just follow him with the ult dashing over the walls. Meanwhile, Octomage chasing, locking him down, and Ray getting the final hit on Nivosi. Fatman Puffin getting hurt by Zaxxent. Orb of Deception just chunking him down. Meanwhile, Ray gets the double kill there on both T-Dominant and Kekkle. Or, I'm sorry, Fatman Puffin. And it looks like they might just end here. Nope.
I don't think they can end. It's smart to go for the top lane and hit right now. 22 seconds of the Batman and T-Dub. So, they only have 3 minions. I don't know if they're going to actually be able to get. It's pretty low.
It's pretty low, and Ray is pretty fed. If you look at his items, he's 11-0-3, has a Phantom Dancer, Skirmisher Saber, Warrior, Yomu's Ghostblade. Does plenty of damage. Objectives aren't going to be standing around very long. Very good charm out of Zaxxent there to actually get the kill on Chino. So overall, Tip and Tipables very handily in the lead, and like I said, once they have that lead, doesn't really escape from them too much. We'll see if they can close it out soon, as Dragon and Baron timers are around the same time, about minute 10 to go for both. And I can't remember what the dragon was.
It's Ocean.
Ocean Dragon is the next next one, and if Tip and Tipples get it, I mean, they can kind of just sit back and heal off all that damage if they get pushed off.
Yeah, Kansu is pushing out bot lane. That is their next goal, because there is 40 seconds of Baron and Dragon. He's gonna steal away the cleave off and have to go down hard. Get that bottom lane inhib, and then as soon as you get Baron, win that team fight, and the game is pretty much over. Not a lot that Team OG can just do. Baron's opting for.
Chino Sensei did get hit by Zaxxent's charm just by the very edge of it. And Raid does throw out the ult to finish it off. Looking at the items, oh, plenty of damage out of Ray. It's gonna be Fatman Puffin getting charmed, Kansu getting the final hit, ult out of Poppy to knock up Nivosi, and Kekkle is just gonna have to dash away. Tough flash, can't get away, and T-Dumin is the only one left to defend. I don't think he's gonna be able to defend this. Gonna get bot inhibitor as well. Meanwhile, super minions crashing into the base. Ray's just taking down turrets left and right. Assault and Battery out of TW on Zaxxent. Chino Sensei does get the kill on Zaxxent, but that is gonna be game one for Tip and Tipables. Very handily, in 28 minutes and 11 seconds, game one, Tip and Tipables. We will be back as soon as game two is ready to go.